Hey, I'm Rhys Millen. We're in Manitou Springs here for the Pikes Peak International Hill Climb Race Week. Race day is on Sunday, just a couple of days from now. We've had a great week testing the new Unlimited car, stepping out of the production Hyundai Genesis Coupe, winning the overall hill climb last year, but in a car that was set for the time attack division. Now handing the keys off to Paul Dallenbach, who's doing a great job all week. Fastest overall by about 12 seconds, looking for a great run, and potentially five consecutive wins for the Genesis Coupe at Pikes Peak. For myself, stepping back into Unlimited in a newly developed car, the Hyundai Genesis PM580T, an old tarmac car, and the car has been performing fantastically all week long, setting second fastest times today and running around 45 seconds quicker than the old Unlimited car. This year is a little different. We have the presence of Peugeot. They're a manufacturer that run events like Le Mans once a year and done very, very well, been very successful there and spent cubic dollars. Their approach has been the same here this year. It's something we didn't plan for, and their times are just amazing. But reflecting back on our program, you know, the car, the budget that we had, the time that we had to build the car, and the times that we're setting are all on par with what we actually planned for before coming here for this race week. So we're really excited, really proud of the car and the team and the performance of the Lambda V6 Hyundai engine. That engine is producing 900 horsepower this year and 800 foot-pounds of torque. It's exceptionally fantastic fun to drive, and it's taking some of the best, Romain Dumas, who just won Le Mans last week, and pipping him in times a couple of sections this week. So we're really excited for race day come Sunday. It's a win for the team if Paul wins. It's a win for the team if I win. It's a double win if we both win. It's a great victory. So to have Paul as a partner and to see him doing so well for the first time in the car, it's a testament to how well balanced the car is. And to be beating on Porsche for the last 2 years and continuing it this year for the third year, it's going to be a great race come Sunday.
Yeah, I've been racing 18 years here on and off. This is my 19th year, I believe, racing the hill climb. First time in the Hyundai Genesis Coupe. Yeah, last year I drove the car that I always drove up here, which was an Unlimited car, and we had a big off when the throttle stuck right at the start, and you know, could have been very serious. I got very lucky and pretty much walked away, even though it destroyed the car. And you know, it's not the way I ever wanted to end my racing career, and I'm glad I was not injured and I was able to come back. And Rhys gave me the opportunity to drive the Genesis Coupe this year because he built a new Unlimited car. And it didn't really take that long for me to decide to say yes. And it's been, so far, it's been really a dream come true driving this car. The car wins up here all the time. It has a winning tradition, and I don't want to be the one that doesn't win in it. You know, the overall thing is not going to happen this year for us because of just how deep the Unlimited field is. So our goal is to break the time attack record that Rhys set last year, win first in class, beat the Porsches, and right now we're on track to do that. Weather permitting, you know, we never know what happens up there. It's just, mountain does strange things on race day. Well, Pikes Peak's a very unique race as it is man against the mountain first, and then it's man against the competitor, and it's you have all the elements basically against you every time you go up there, and you just have to be the one to come on top and be the one that makes it the best day, because it's one of those things where you can have one bad corner and your race is done. You only get one shot at this mountain, and she's very evil. She has bit me several times. We have had a lot of close calls where we should have won. I was able to win six times. I think I should have won probably 13 times up here, but she's got to race the mountain the way it is presented to you that day, and whatever happens, happens.
We're here at 12,000 feet at Pikes Peak, and Mr. Millen and Mr. Dallenbach just finished their practice runs today on the upper section. Paul was clearly very fast in his group, as was Rhys. It's going to make for an exciting race day. We'll see a lot of exciting things in terms of different setups from different teams, but I think our cars are dialed in, and we'll have a good day tomorrow. It's sunny and about 85 degrees right here today, but tomorrow it could be totally different. It could snow, it could rain, we could have hail. So Rhys and Paul really will race the mountain, and that's the key to this, to be successful. So we've got some good competitors from Porsche, Peugeot. It's gonna be an exciting day. Rhys Millen is running an unlimited car powered by a 4.1 liter Lambda V6 Hyundai engine. He's pushing north of 800 horsepower in that car. Hyundai has backed the development of that car, giving him things like an electronic power steering box to set up the car with, and helping with some engineering work on that. Paul Dallenbach is driving a Hyundai Genesis Coupe, a very, very successful car. It is the current world record holding car for the mountain. And Paul is a very skilled and veteran driver, will be driving that car. That car has been run in multiple disciplines, from Formula Drift to Time Attack racing. It is a really well-disciplined car, very, very thoroughly engineered at this point, and very proven. So Paul is gonna really look to break the Time Attack record against the Porsches.
Another year and another wild ride up Pikes Peak, finishing second overall in the unlimited division for myself, and Paul Dallenbach claiming victory. Once again, 5 years in a row, the Hyundai Genesis Coupe has been undefeated in Time Attack division. All in all, a fantastic week. We drove smart today, drove the car into second place, had no issues with the engine, ran flawlessly, probably hitting speeds 5-6 miles an hour quicker than practice, just by the sheer power and reliability of the engine. The road was a little colder on the upper section, so we just dialed it back to conserve the car, keep it in one piece, and get it to the finish line. 9:02, 4 seconds slower than my bogey time, but it was easy 4 seconds in the car if I needed to push it for second place.
Well, we're up at the top. We ended up in first place, breaking the record barely, but it was a difficult run. The track was slippery, and we lost our brakes kind of towards the top, but had a little weather element, but Hyundai Genesis Coupe didn't let me down. We finished first, beat the record by a tenth of a second, so I think this car is going to be retired now. It's undefeated up here at Pikes Peak, and I'm just really happy. Rhys was excited. He's jumping up and down, and a win for me is a win for him. You know, this is his team, and he had faith in me, and I was able to deliver for him. I'm very happy. And, wish I could have gone a little faster, but it just wasn't there for me today. I guess at the end of the day, it really doesn't matter. Last year, it was not my day, and this year, it is my day.
You know, another year, another crazy ride up Pikes Peak. Wild ride, that is.
Nicely done.
Thank you.
All right.